bought a new car. Shut up. You bought a new house. Shut up. Are you in a good relationship? Shut up. Are you making good money? Shut up. Because people can't destroy what they don't know. Silence is often the best shield against envy and negativity. So win in silence, celebrate in silence, and let your success speak for itself.
Is it worth it?
Oh yeah, it's worth it. If you're strong enough.
There will always be people that try to stop you from reaching your full potential. But answer me this. When's the last time you saw somebody stop a train? Trading is a crazy business. $50 per month today can become $500 per month in 365 days. $500 per month today can become $5,000 per month in 365 days. $5,000 per month today can become $50,000 per month in 365 days. Stop wasting time and start taking action. 30-day challenge for future millionaires. Wake up before 7 a.m. Start a side hustle. Don't waste money. Work out 6 times a week. Don't waste time. Set goals every day. Follow me if you are in.
There's a lot here to be excited about. I think this could be very positive for our society and economy.
Trading is a different business. It's not a typical 9-to-5 job. There's no manual, no guarantees. Every day is a new challenge, a new opportunity. It's what sets us apart from the rest. If you're a proud trader, drop a fire emoji in the comments. I am working while you are partying. I am working while you are sleeping. I am working while you are depressed, sitting in your room and complaining about everything happens in life. Do you notice something? We are different, so don't wonder why our results are not the same. In trading, you're on your own. You spend lots of time looking at charts, staying up late to study, and always wondering if you made the right choice. Most people don't understand the excitement when you make a good trade or the lessons when things don't go right. But think about it. Every trader who's doing well now was once doubted by others. Stay focused, believe in yourself, and let your wins do the talking. Trading is 90% psychology and 10% technicals. Fix your mind and watch what happens.
Become a ghost. Forget attention. Just grow in private.
Trading is not for weak people. You need to have patience, discipline, confidence, consistency, and emotional control. That's why... A muscular body. It's something that a lot of people want. It's such a beautiful thing because it's not for sale. You have to put the work in order to get it. This quote hit deep in me. Listen this. The one who follows the crowd will usually go no further than the crowd. And those who walk alone are likely to find themselves in places no one has ever been before.
I didn't even create a plan B or even get my mind set up for a plan B because my plan A was gonna work no matter what I did.
Rule number 6. If the plan doesn't work, change the plan, but never the goal.
Loneliness doesn't mean you're weak. It means you are strong enough to wait for what you deserve.
The 1%. This is a group of people that do what the other 99% don't. They separate themselves from the crowd by constantly pushing through discomfort. They work when others don't.
There is no growth without pain. A warrior is someone who gets up even when he can't.
There's half a year left. So in this next chapter of your life, make sure that you win. A wise man once said, "Hate has 4 letters, but so does love. Enemies have 7 letters, but so does friends. Lying has 5 letters, but so does truth. Cry has 3 letters, but so does joy. Negativity has 10 letters, but so does positivity. Life is two-sided, choose the better side of it. When you first get into trading, don't tell anybody that you're trading. Don't tell your family and don't tell your friends. Do not tell anybody. There is not a single person in this world who understands trading like a trader. Only a trader understands the patience and the discipline required and how much time it takes to be successful. Every single person around you is going to say it's gambling, that you're risking everything, and that it's a waste of time. But great things take time, so be patient and keep going. My parents are not rich, but I have never slept hungry, never walked without shoes. So trust me, I have no other dream than making them proud. Trading isn't just buying and selling. It's really about who you are inside. Some days are hard and some days are good. But remember, it's like running a long race, not a quick one. So if you ever feel unsure, take a moment, think about your plan, and remember why you started. 30-day challenge for future millionaires. Wake up before 7 a.m. Start a side hustle. Don't waste money. Work out 6 times a week. Don't waste time. Set goals every day. Follow me if you are in. Trading is like learning to ride a bike. There'll be falls, and sometimes you might want to quit. But every time you get back up, you get better. People might say it's too risky or it's not for you. But remember, the best things come from hard work and not giving up. So keep pushing, learn from each trade, and enjoy the ride.
This is where you gotta push past your limits. If you don't, then your path ends here.
You have to work every single day. I think that's where your confidence comes from. Because when nobody's looking, that's the time that really counts. That's the time that really matters.
The older you get, the more you choose calm over chaos and distance over disrespect. Drama becomes intolerable to you, and your peace becomes your ultimate priority. You start surrounding yourself with people who are good for your mental health, heart, and soul.
We only get to play this game once. Life. You get one chance. Make it or screw it up. How do you want to spend it? Apologizing? Regretting? Hating yourself? How about chasing after people that don't see you? One life, one chance. No more wasting time.
Just be yourself. People don't have to like you. And you don't have to care. You can't change how people feel about you. So don't even try. Just live your life and be happy.
I was quiet. Not blind. My eyes are fine. There are just times I find that silence will get me all the answers I need. Not violence. I didn't do it for you. I chose kindness for me.
Becoming the best version of yourself comes with a lot of goodbyes. Sadly, the only way some people will learn to appreciate you is to lose you. Sometimes you just need to disconnect and enjoy your own company. Change is uncomfortable but necessary. Today's pain is tomorrow's power.
Stay focused. Don't listen to nobody. What's on your mind, just do it. Because what's destined for you, you're going to get it.
Never regret a day in your life. Good day, give happiness. Bad day, give experience. The worst day, give lesson. And the best day, give a memories.
Be grateful. Be grateful for why you can't figure it out. Can't understand why you're so awesome. Can't figure out why you're so great. Can't figure out why you're so ahead of your time. Can't figure out why you have answers to things that no one even knows the question to. Be grateful for that.
Just try to find a way to get 1% better each day. It doesn't need to be something radical. It doesn't need to be something huge. But habits are easy to overlook.
Here's something I learned the hard way. You either say how you feel and mess things up, or you say nothing and let it mess you up instead.
Is it worth it?
Oh yeah, it's worth it. If you're strong enough.
You don't start things and not finish them. You don't quit. There's nothing that comes out of quitting, besides knowing that you didn't finish. We finish everything. You start it, finish it. If you're gonna do it to try and be the best.
Don't complain!
Don't talk negative. That's average people talk normal. Average people talk problems. The greats talk solutions.
Rule number 85. Believe in yourself and all that you are. Know that there is something inside you that is greater than any obstacle.
We become what we think about most of the time. And that's the strangest secret. This is why thinking is so vital. This is why a goal is so important. Because we will become that.
Persistence is the unwavering force that propels us forward, even when faced with seemingly insurmountable challenges. It is the silent engine that fuels our dreams and ambitions, driving us to persevere when others may falter.
Lazy people do a little work and think they should be winning, but winners work as hard as possible and still worry if they're being lazy.
Everyone must choose one of two pains. The pain of discipline or the pain of regret.
What's the best advice you've ever received?
What if it can turn out better than you can imagine?
Remember how worthless they made you feel. Now turn your anger into power and show them off. Be better than them. The best advice anyone ever gave me was two words. You can't. And you know what my response was? Two words. Watch me.
There's a lot here to be excited about. I think this could be very positive for our society and economy.
People have a certain energy about them. When there are people in the world that are focused and like I wake up in the morning with a purpose. This is what I'm doing. You can feel that energy. So those are the people that I tend to work with a lot. And if you don't have that, I can sense it. If you're a person that's very distracted, hanging around the wrong crowd, not having that sense of purpose, we don't want to be around them. Because that stuff will bring you down, man.
I respect someone who has the balls to tell me they can't stand me to my face. It's way better than those spineless fakes who play nice up front but stab me in the back the moment I turn around.
You're not on my level. You will never be on my level. Period. It's okay to be number two. It's okay to be right behind me. It's okay.
Yeah, in my white tee.
Rule number 40. Don't let someone who's never been in your shoes tell you how to tie them.
Whatever they decided I couldn't do is exactly what I did.
You ain't no boy no more. This ain't no bass. This ain't no I want to go party. Now it's time to create a legacy now. You had your fun. Now get your work. Hollywood Code.
30-day challenge for future millionaires. Wake up before 7 a.m. Start a side hustle. Don't waste money. Work out 6 times a week. Don't waste time. Set goals every day. Follow me if you are in.
There's a lot here to be excited about. I think this could be very positive.
You may not be where you want to be yet in life, but you're also not where you used to be. Take a second to realize how far you've come. Now put your head down and get back.
Rule number 42. Never trust someone who has let you down more than 2 times. Once was a warning, twice was a lesson, and anything more than that is simply taking advantage. Rule number 18. If it's meant to be, it will be. You won't have to force, convince, or worry over it. Let it flow, let it be, and let it come to you. You're attracting everything you need.
Rule number every day. Don't wait for the opportunity. Create it.
The only difference between me and you is I wanted it more. I wanted it more.
Rule number 14. To get over the past, you first have to accept that the past is over. No matter how many times you revisit it, analyze it, regret it, sweat it, it's over. It can't hurt you anymore.
I have a question for you. If you could go back in time to one day in your life and relive one single moment, what would it be?
Rule number 98. If you don't fail, you're not even trying. To get something you never had, you need to do something you never did.
You are valuable, you're important, and you have to take care of yourself.
This is a message to all the haters out there. If you don't like what I do, but you watch everything I'm doing, you're still a fan.
Sometimes, the best thing you can do is not think, not wonder, not imagine, not obsess. Just breathe and have faith that everything will work out for the best.
Rule number one. Believe in yourself, even when no one else does.
Rule number one. Roses are red, violets are blue. I'm a future millionaire, my dreams will come true. It doesn't matter how long it takes to reach my goals. It doesn't matter how many obstacles are put in my way. If I want to achieve something, I'll get it done. Maturing is realizing you don't want to be around drama, stress, or conflict anymore. You start choosing calm over chaos and distance over disrespect. You start prioritizing your peace, mental health, and happiness over everything.
Whenever you feel negative or unhappy about anything, you say, wait a minute, I'm responsible. I'm responsible for my life. I'm responsible for what happens. I can't change the past, so I'm not going to spend a second worrying about the past. I'm going to become so busy working on my future and my goals that I don't have time to think about the past.
Be happy with what you have while working for what you want. Focus on becoming a better version of yourself every day and let your progress be your motivation. Discipline and obsession will take you further than passion ever will. The past is in your head. The future is in your hands.
You know what? Life is short. Okay? And you can't go around life carrying baggage. Can't go around life carrying resentment. Just can't do it. It's too short. You know what I mean? So you have to forgive and move on.
Sometimes God takes you on a journey you didn't know you needed to bring you everything you ever wanted. Trust the plan.
Remember, every morning you have two choices. Continue to sleep with your dreams or wake up and chase them. You post a pic on Instagram and you get 10 likes. You post the same pic on your story and get 400 views. The moral of the story is not many people like you, but they're watching.
You cannot change your life unless you change something. If you always do what you always did, you'll always get what you always got.
Did you know there's a recession coming? People are going to lose their house, their cars. They won't be able to eat because there will be no job anymore. And you got to be prepared for that. How do you face that situation? Super simple. I will give you one step. Only one step. You're going to take 10% of all your revenues, all your profit, any money you receive, you take 10% in cash money. We're still using money, right? So get that money. Go to the bank every time you get your pay. Take 10% in cash money. Keep it in a sure place or on you. I don't know. You decide for your own security, but you need that cash money. I explain why. If the institution closed, all your investment, you won't have access to it. So you need that cash money to survive. You say, well, I'm gonna be my bills. Negotiate. Go call the companies, negotiate, but make sure that you're able to keep 10% of all your revenues, profit, paycheck, in cash money. Okay? It's very important. At least if something happened, you'll have that money to be able to get back on your feet by the time you find a job, by the time the forex go back and you'll be able to trade again, and by the time the Wall Street go come back, by the time the real estate.
If you came across this video, you are on the right track. It doesn't matter what you do, how old you are, what country you live in. I promise you that you will succeed. Because while people are wasting their time watching stupid videos, you are watching videos to improve yourself, even on social media. That's why this video came your way. Even the social media algorithm is aware of the fire burning inside you. Just be patient and keep working. You will succeed.
When everything goes well for you financially, beware. Put money aside. Don't buy anything. Don't invest. Don't do nothing. Nothing crazy. Absolutely. You just buy what you need and save. And be prepared. Because when everything goes well for you, it means something bad is coming. So if you save, if you got your money, you pay your bills, and you don't do no crazy move, no crazy things with your money, you stay wise, when difficult time will come, it'll be easy for you. You'll have all the opportunity to buy because everything's going to be cheap. Why? Because people won't be able to buy it. So you're going to be able to get this, get that, buy this, get great deals, invest, and make a lot of money. So when everything goes well, beware. Fake news. Everything, bad times are coming. And everything is... when everything is bad for you, everything will be perfect, great, amazing, because you'll maximize all your profit.
Every day is a new beginning. Take a deep breath. Smile. Start again.
In the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth, and the earth was without form and void, and darkness was upon the face of the deep, and the Spirit of God moved upon the face of the waters. And God said, Let there be light, and there was light. And God saw the light that it was good.
If you came across this video, you are on the right track. It doesn't matter what you do, how old you are, what country you live in. I promise you that you will succeed. Because while people are wasting their time watching stupid videos, you are watching videos to improve yourself, even on social media. That's why this video came your way. Even the social media algorithm is aware of the fire burning inside you. Just be patient and keep working. You will succeed. The biggest lesson I learned this year is to not force anything. Conversations, relationships, friendships, attention, love. If it's forced, it's not worth fighting for. If it flows, it flows. If it crashes, it crashes. It is what it is. And remember, if it hurts, let it go. It's not meant to be. I am working while you are partying. I am working while you are sleeping. I am working while you are depressed, sitting in your room and complaining about everything happens in life. Do you notice something? We are different. So don't wonder why our results are not the same.
Right now my focus is peace and happiness. I feel like I owe that to myself.
I am not motivated. I am disciplined. Know the difference. I do what needs to be done regardless of how I feel. Do it tired. Do it scared. Do it sad. Just get it done. When you love someone who doesn't love you back, don't force them. Let them go. Let them live their life with the person they love, as it's the only way to prove your love to them. Never fight for their love, because love isn't about battles, but rather about affection, tenderness, understanding, friendship, and solidarity. Love isn't a war you have to fight. When a person doesn't love you, it means they won't love you. You have to understand that this is life. We don't get always what we want. Strive to succeed in life. Continue on your path. And the day we meet the right person, you'll understand why it didn't work out with the others.
One day, the people that don't even believe in you will tell everyone how they met you. I'm only
human. The devil wouldn't be attacking you so hard if there wasn't something valuable inside of you. Remember, thieves don't break into empty homes.
Always remember, in your weakest moments, the strongest version of you is waiting to be born.
You cannot win the war against the world
if you can't win the war against your own mind.
Imagine you're standing in front of God and he's reading out a list about you. Muscular, successful, brave, gentleman, helped people in the world and made an impact. And you wonder, that wasn't me. And then he says, but that was who you were supposed to become.
I'm sick and tired of putting effort into people who will never put the effort back. I can no longer be just an option to you. It's time to make you obsolete. Always remember, never back down.
The 1%. This is a group of people that do what the other 99% don't. They separate themselves from the crowd by constantly pushing through discomfort. They work when others don't. I am in a point in life now where I don't need to initiate conversation with anyone. If you want to talk to me, come say hi. Other than that, I'm on a mission. Everyone who ever rejected you, left you, insulted you, doesn't believe in you, bet against you, is watching you. Give them a good show.
You're tired? Great. Get to work. You're heartbroken? Great. Get to work. Because if you can show up to work every single day despite of what you're going through, you're going to develop an unstoppable version of yourself.
You have to change your mindset. You have to change your routine. You have to cut people out of your life that are dragging you down with them. You have to find that motivation deep down in you and spark that fuse.
Rule number 17. Everything happens for a reason, and that reason causes change. Sometimes it hurts, sometimes it's hard, but in the end, it's all for the best.
I will train so hard that those around me think I am insane, so that I can become the strongest and most resilient warrior alive.
Success is nothing more than a few simple disciplines, practiced every day. Just start something today, repeat it tomorrow and the day after, and you'll see success comes to you.
People think I'm crazy because I found a whole nother way of living. I think they're crazy for never even trying to get to the other side of whatever's in front of them. So what drives me every day is finding more of myself.
Always remember, the bigger the risk, the bigger the reward.
Your future needs you. Your past doesn't. Don't give up.
The consistency of work. Monday, get better. Tuesday, get better. Wednesday, get better. Right? And you do that over a period of time. You know?
If it was easy, everyone would do it. Remember that the next time you're about to quit.
If you don't have the mindset that you're the best ever, you failed already. Before you can ever reach anything, you have to believe it. You don't just mistakenly become great at something.
Life is like a gym. If you look over to the right, there will always be somebody in better shape than you. But if you look to your left, there's someone who would die to be in your position.
Success is 1% dreaming and 99% doing. You build your future. It's not handed to you.
The best advice anyone ever gave me was two words. You can't. And you know what my response was? Two words. Watch me.
Never underestimate a man who picks self-improvement after being disrespected by people he loved. He will conquer everything.
A bodybuilder won't judge you for working out. A millionaire won't judge you for starting a business. A football player won't judge you for playing ball. It's always the low-life losers who have something to say.
Every day is just constant improvement, constant curiosity, constantly getting better. The results don't really matter. It's the figuring out that matters.
It's all in your mind. Whatever you hold in your mind will tend to occur in your life. If you continue to believe as you have always believed, you will continue to act as you have always acted. You will continue to get what you have always gotten. If you want different results in your life, all you have to do is change your mind.
Always remember, you will never be criticized by someone who is doing more than you. You will only be criticized by someone doing less. Isn't it weird how so many versions of you exist in people's mind? Some know you as the shy person that doesn't talk. Some see you as the annoying person that won't shut up. Some see you cold and mean. Others find you caring and kind.
Everything in this world is temporary.
Life changes. People come and go. And seasons never last. Always remember that your present situation is not your final destination.
I don't care how good you are in anything. You don't have discipline. You ain't nobody.
Right.
You're nothing without discipline. Because you give up on the slightest struggle without discipline. Discipline is doing what you hate to do, but do it like you love it.
What is discipline? Discipline is when you don't feel like it, but you do it anyway. Discipline is when you are tired. You want to turn off the alarm and sleep in, but you get your ass up and do what needs to be done. So it's time to become unbeatable and conquer the world.
When you build in silence, people don't know what to attack.
Rule number 85. Believe in yourself and all that you are. Know that there is something inside you that is greater than any obstacle.
Genesis chapter 1. In the beginning God created the heaven and the earth, and the earth was without form and void, and darkness was upon the face of the deep. And the Spirit of God moved upon the face of the waters. And God said, Let there be light. And there was light. And God saw the light that it was good. And God divided the light from the darkness. And God called the light day, and the darkness he called night. And the evening and the morning were the first day. And God said, Let there be a firmament in the midst of the waters, and let it divide the waters from the waters. And God made the firmament, and divided the waters which were under the firmament from the waters which were above the firmament. And it was so. And God called the firmament heaven, and the evening and the morning were the second day. And God said, Let the waters under the heaven be gathered together unto one place, and let the dry land appear. And it was so. God called the dry land earth, and the gathering together of the waters called he seas, and God saw that it was good. And God said, Let the earth bring forth grass, the herb yielding seed, and the fruit tree yielding fruit after his kind, whose seed is in itself upon the earth. And it was so. And the earth brought forth grass, and herb yielding seed after his kind, and the tree yielding fruit, whose seed was in itself after his kind. And God saw that it was good. And the evening and the morning were the third day. And God said, Let there be lights in the firmament of the heaven to divide the day from the night, and let them be for signs and for seasons and for days and years, and let them be for lights in the firmament of the heaven to give light upon the earth. And it was so. And God made two great lights, the greater light to rule the day, and the lesser light to rule the night. He made the stars also. God set them in the firmament of the heaven to give light upon the earth, and to rule over the day and over the night, and to divide the light from the darkness. And God saw that it was good. And the evening and the morning were the fourth day. God said, Let the waters bring forth abundantly the moving creature that hath life, and fowl that may fly above the earth in the open firmament of heaven. And God created great whales and every living creature that moveth, which the waters brought forth abundantly after their kind, and every winged fowl after his kind. God saw that it was good. And God blessed them, saying, Be fruitful, and multiply, and fill the waters in the seas, and let fowl multiply in the earth. And the evening and the morning were the fifth day. And God said, Let the earth bring forth the living creature after his kind, cattle and creeping thing, and beast of the earth after his kind. And it was so. And God made the beast of the earth after his kind, and cattle after their kind, and everything that creepeth upon the earth after his kind. And God saw that it was good. And God said, Let us make man in our image, after our likeness, and let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the fowl of the air, and over the cattle, and over all the earth, and over every creeping thing that creepeth upon the earth. So God created man in his own image. In the image of God created he him. Male and female created he them. And God blessed them, and God said unto them, Be fruitful, and multiply, and replenish the earth, and subdue it, and have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the fowl of the air, and over every living thing that moveth upon the earth. And God said, Behold, I have given you every herb-bearing seed which is upon the face of all the earth, and every tree in which is the fruit of a tree yielding seeds, to you it shall be for meat. And to every beast of the earth, and to every fowl of the air, and to everything that creepeth upon the earth wherein there is life, I have given every green herb for meat. And it was so. And God saw everything that he had made, and behold, it was very good. And the evening and the morning were the sixth day.
There's a lot here to be excited about. I think this could be very positive for our society and economy.
Chapter 2. Thus the heavens and the earth were finished in all the host of them. And on the seventh day God ended his work which he had made, and he rested on the seventh day from all his work which he had made. And God blessed the seventh day and sanctified it, because that in it he had rested from all his work which God created and made. These are the generations of the heavens and of the earth when they were created, in the day that the Lord God made the earth and the heavens, and every plant of the field before it was in the earth, and every herb of the field before it grew. For the Lord God had not caused it to rain upon the earth, and there was not a man to till the ground. But there went up a mist from the earth and watered the whole face of the ground. And the Lord God formed man of the dust of the ground, and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life, and man became a living soul. And the Lord God planted a garden eastward in Eden, and there he put the man whom he had formed. And out of the ground made the Lord God to grow every tree that is pleasant to the sight, and good for food, the tree of life also in the midst of the garden, and the tree of knowledge of good and evil. And a river went out of Eden to water the garden, and from thence it was parted and became into four heads. The name of the first is Pison. That is it which encompasseth the whole land of Havilah, where there is gold. And the gold of that land is good. There is Delium and the onyx stone. And the name of the second river is Gihon. The same is it that compasseth the whole land of Ethiopia. And the name of the third river is Hiddekel, that is it which goeth toward the east of Assyria, and the fourth river is Euphrates. And the Lord God took the man, and put him in the garden of Eden to dress it and to keep it. And the Lord God commanded the man, saying, Of every tree of the garden thou mayest freely eat, but of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil thou shalt not eat of it, for in the day that thou eatest thereof thou shalt surely die. And the Lord God said, It is not good that the man should be alone. I will make him an helpmeet for him. And out of the ground the Lord God formed every beast of the field and every fowl of the air, and brought them unto Adam to see what he would call them. And whatsoever Adam called every living creature, that was the name thereof. And Adam gave names to all cattle, and to the fowl of the air, and to every beast of the field. But for Adam there was not found an helpmeet for him. And the Lord God caused a deep sleep to fall upon Adam, and he slept. And he took one of his ribs, and closed up the flesh instead thereof. And the rib, which the Lord God had taken from man, made he a woman, and brought her unto the man. And Adam said, This is now bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman, because she was taken out of man. Therefore shall a man leave his father and his mother, and shall cleave unto his wife, and they shall be one flesh. And they were both naked, the man and his wife, and were not ashamed.
When you build in silence, people don't know what to attack.